So over the past month, I have been dealing with one of the most strange and frustrating situations with my MacBook Pro. I called it the MacBook problem in one of my more recent videos. Essentially, the computer went haywire, and the program involved with the Mac search bar, Spotlight, was causing some major performance issues. I mean, super duper lag, less than 1 hour of battery, and the fans going crazy. It got to the point where I didn't even want to use my laptop in class because that thing would draw so much attention. I mean, those classes are quiet. You can hear a pin drop. That quiet. So I didn't want to pull this thing out. Therefore, I was quite frustrated because work was super difficult to complete on a daily basis. And I really didn't know what to do. Until 1 week ago, I was able to resolve this problem with a bit of tenacity and perseverance, but also a lot of luck too. So I want to tell you how I was able to fix this problem if and or when it comes up for you. Because apparently this is kinda common. So this is the MacBook problem solution. So we're going to split this video into two sections. One being the typical solutions that are successful for most, and the other being the unorthodox solutions that I can't really explain how they worked. But they did. So let's talk about it. First, let's talk about the typical solutions to solving this problem that most people would find useful. So with MacBooks, Spotlight, the search bar, needs to index or sort all of your files to make searching for them far easier. Think of it like organizing laundry. It's possible to put them all over the floor, but it's way more efficient to put them in their dedicated spaces, like a closet. That's what the program MDS Stores does for Spotlight. And on a typical basis, your Mac will index or sort all of these files in the background. Until one day, when for whatever reason, it might take a day or two to get that done, which could be a bit taxing on your computer's performance. And in the worst case scenarios, it can last a long time. For me, over 200 hours. Because your Mac can get stuck sometimes. So here's what I got for what you should try. 3 steps. Number one, continue indexing. Yes, sometimes this is the best solution. Despite how frustrating it may be, most PCs are pretty capable on their own. So by us constantly interrupting them, we might cause more harm than good. I'd say for a baseline, give it a whole 24 hours. This means leaving your Mac on. Don't allow it to go to sleep and do not shut it down. Pro tip, don't turn the laptop off. That will restart the whole process. Coming from experience. So just go to your settings, turn off the sleep cycle when your laptop is plugged in, and just allow it to do its thing. And now if that doesn't work, you can modify the indexing. This includes straight up restarting it with this code, or even preventing certain files or drives from being sorted. See the screen for the directions. And if all else fails with that, you can straight up stop the indexing, which should be last line, because that means no Spotlight, which also means no search bar. So you can type this code into your terminal to stop the indexing, and that should do the trick. But it didn't for me. For some reason, Spotlight just kept coming back up, and the problem wouldn't resolve. So I was stuck with a stubborn and defective Mac during the worst time of the year. Final season. So I had to do something. Something drastic. And something not really technical. This is where we enter the unorthodox section. So during this problem, I had received a continuous notification that I need to get my laptop serviced, which I'll definitely get to. The problem was, I was 1.5 hours away from the nearest Apple store, and I had no way to get there. So that was not an option. So oftentimes, when I'm dealing with a tech problem, the first thing I'll do is to look it up online to find the best solution, which is what you saw with the typical solutions. But if that doesn't work, it's time to fiddle. So what I did was let Spotlight run for 100-ish hours, so a few days and nights, and then immediately force quit it. Now I know what you're thinking, why the heck would you stop it? Well, because it was stuck. I knew that. But if I was able to force quit it at the right time and not shut the PC down, Spotlight would not return. One of the things for Spotlight for me is, if I force quit it, it will come back up. Almost immediately. But at one point, I force quit it so many times that it straight up gave up. This is not a technical solution by any means, so service your laptop if you can. But I force quit it and force quit it so many times that it eventually poofed. Vanished. I was safe. It was incredible having the PC back and the fans not going wild. For once. But here's the thing. I could not turn the computer off. Therefore, the amount of just random lag and performance drops during my exams was just wild. At some point, it would take a full second for the computer to register which multiple choice answer I put, which was just wild. But that is way better than having that, plus the crazy fans, and the computer's battery not surviving my full 2-hour exam. So it was definitely a sacrifice, but it got the job done. So I survived. Overall, my spotlight situation was not ideal, but also not uncommon. I understand that for many people, you won't need to do what I did. But for the select few who eventually come across this problem, definitely make sure to keep this video in mind. Fret not though, I still love and use my MacBook Pro and will get this poor thing serviced when I come back from my friend's graduation. Because it definitely needs to get checked. It took 3 hours to recognize this microphone for whatever reason. So thank you for enduring the situation. I'm back now. Thankfully. So, as always, my name is Cyrus. It's spelled like Cyrus, but not like C Rooster. Just take out the terror. Thank you very much for watching, and have a wonderful day. Peace.